What's going on, guys? Welcome back to NCAA Football 14 Road to Glory. And here we are getting started with the high school season. We've got 7 weeks to get through. Grab some popcorn. It's going to be a long one. We got a lot of touchdowns coming your way. And we'll get started here in week one against the Highland Park Leathernecks at home. So we'll get started from about the 25-yard line. Quarterback in the shotgun will drop back the pass. I'm running a short curl. This one is thrown late. And nice play there by the corner as that one was knocked away. Second down and 10 going to the ground. Taking out that same corner who deflected the pass. And look at the running back down the sideline. He's got room to run, but he's going to get tripped up at about the 40-yard line. Second and 10 here, still in this opening drive for the Tigers as we'll go to the post route. This one's going to be thrown. It's caught for a first down. And I get away from one. Can't get away from the second. But that one good for 18 yards. Not a bad way to start the game out. Second and goal here from the 10. Quarterback in the shotgun once again, turning that curl route into a slant as I'm running across the middle. Touchdown, Tigers. And we get our first points of the season via a 10-yard touchdown. Next drive getting started around the 40-yard line. Quarterback drops back to pass. They're not going to let me have that corner route. So I'm running right up the middle of the field, getting down to the 35. And that's good for 28. That drive ended up in an interception, so we get another drive started here as I'm running a curl route. Quarterback taking all day to throw the football, and this one is knocked out of my hands. Even as a balanced receiver, I'm still dropping these passes. 4th and 13 here, we're getting a punt return as we can't get anything going on that previous drive, and I'll go ahead and kick this one to the outside of the field. Nice move, getting away from one and getting down to about the 32 or 33-yard line, return for a gain of 21 yards. First quarter almost wrapped up. This one's going to be caught for a near first down, good for about 9 yards. So here we are in the second quarter as I'm running another curl route. And I'm turning that curl into a slant route once again. This one's going to get down to about the 2 or the 3, gain of 17 yards. When I make my way to college, I'll definitely be making sure I'm running my routes because I'm pretty sure people are going to complain about me not running them. But here in high school, I just do not care as Alex had a 3-yard touchdown run as I take out the corner and secure a touchdown for him. 14-0 lead. We'll get started on another drive here about midfield. This one's caught, getting us down to about the 20-yard line. Nice catch there as it'll be second down and 7. And they're not covering the middle of the field, and the quarterback's throwing this one, and I couldn't see where the football was going, so I didn't catch the football. 3rd and 7 here, turning that curl, going upfield, and the quarterback, for some reason, threw this pass. I didn't call for it, and it's intercepted. His second in the game, and we definitely didn't want that to happen. 1st and 10 here, 14-0 lead still. In high school mode, these teams are not going to be too competitive going against you. This one's caught, getting upfield, breaking one tackle, breaking two, and getting down inside the 25-yard line. I'm not having a shabby first half. 8 catches, 113 yards, 1 touchdown, 3rd and 14 here. Quarterback's going to lob this one down the field, and this one is incomplete. Nearly intercepted by two players, and coach wants to go for it here on 4th and 14. So we're running verticals once again. I'm going to try to turn this into a curl route, try to make the catch, but this one's going to be a touchdown. The Thien win for 28 yards. He ran the same route I did last time, and the quarterback just put this one up there. And this time, I mean, look at the corner. Didn't even jump. If I was over there, that would have been incomplete. 1 minute left here in the first half as the quarterback will drop back once again, throwing to the vertical route. It's caught for a first down, and look at that play right there. Touchdown, 48 yards. Oh, man, this is going to get real here in the high school mode as that's going to be my second touchdown on the game, and this one was pretty solid. Caught the football, turned around, just told that guy to get off me, and I'm in the end zone for the touchdown as I just fall because I didn't have any stamina left. 32 seconds left here. Quarterback will throw this one down the field once again, and it's going to be another touchdown. As that one was supposed to be an in route, and I turned that into a streak once again. 41 yards on that one. Fourth quarter just getting started up. 42-0. Another vertical route here, but I'm going to the outside trying to buy some room, and this one's caught, getting us down to about the 15-yard line. 1st and 10 from the 15-yard line, going to the curl route. This one's going to be bump and run cover to get past my man, and it's caught in the end zone for another touchdown, this one from 14 yards, and that'll do it here for week one. 49-0 win. Obviously, the play of the game was, this is probably the play of the season. I don't think anything's going to beat that. Checking out my stats for the game, 14 catches, 275 yards, 4 touchdowns, 2 drops, 237 recruiting points, getting me to a 1-caliber rating or 1-star caliber rating. After that game, I'm getting looked at by Western Kentucky, Kentucky, and Northern Illinois. I decided to go with Northern Illinois in this situation, the Huskies, hometown team, kind of in a way. And here we go, 1st down and 10 against East Peoria in week 2. And this play is going to be going all the way down inside the 10-yard line, 35-yard gain on the first catch of the game. Third and goal here from the 5-yard line as the quarterback dropped back looking for me in the end zone. This one's going to be intercepted. And that is definitely not how we wanted our first possession to go. But this one's going to get called back because of a pass interference call. That defensive lineman that dropped back, he was definitely in the way. Second and 5 here, up by 7 points, going to the corner route. This one is completely underthrown. Not enough air under the pass. This time the interception will count for number 19. As he's trying to take this one all the way back to the end zone, but it's fumbled. And this one is going to be recovered by a Tiger. That was a pretty interesting play. Our quarterback has to put some air under these footballs. It's not going to be a very, very fun season with him underthrowing the football like this. But look at Michael Weisbecker, the tight end, coming out of nowhere, forcing the fumble. And it's going to be recovered by Thien Nguyen. And we'll get the ball back at about midfield. First and 10 here, a minute left here as I'm going to be running a streak. Forget the curl route, going for the touchdown. And this one is underthrown. Put some air under the football. That one could have gone for 6. First and 10 here, first quarter almost wrapped up. Running a streak, forget the curl once again. Getting down the field and the animation caused me to go out of bounds. That could have been a touchdown. 10 seconds left here, going to the outside. Quarterback throwing this one late and another interception for number 19. This quarterback is either throwing the ball late or he's just not putting enough air under the football. It's getting annoying. First and 10 here, going to the in route. That one caught for a first down. We got to get something going here, because we're already in the second quarter, only up by 7. First and goal here, going to the corner route. This one's going to be wide open. This one's going to be caught and dropped. Oh my goodness. I dropped the catch. This is an issue. This is going to be such an issue. My catch rating needs to be worked on, even with the balanced wide receiver. Still not making these catches. I could have caught that in high school. That's one of the big reasons why I went with balanced wide receiver for this Road to Glory, is because I kind of wanted to keep it realistic to what I could do in high school, and I was definitely not the fastest guy. I think I ran like a 4.4, maybe like a 4.45 in high school. It was a mid 4.4, not too quick, not slow at all. I mean, I could definitely burn people if you weren't paying attention to me, but I definitely feel like I fall under balance a lot more than speed, because I had pretty solid hands in high school. They called me Young Moss. That was not my nickname. Oh, in high school, I just made that up. I would literally quit playing football if that was my nickname in high school. But that, fortunately, was not it. That sounds like some rapper that cares about the environment. Young Moss, caring about the trees and the animals and all that crap. But my nickname in high school was Vader, obviously because of my voice, like Darth Vader, because I don't even know. But not many people call me Vader. I think my coach my first 2 years called me Vader sometimes, but mostly everyone called me by my name. I probably should have made that stick around, because Vader sounds a lot cooler than Megatron. If you really think about it, I mean, like Vader, Darth Vader. I mean, that sounds so much cooler than Megatron. But the whole reason behind people calling me that is obviously because of the way my voice is. My voice has been like this since, I think, my freshman year. That summer between 8th grade and freshman year, my voice has been like this, and it changed way before everyone else. And it really, really, I mean, it was for pretty long years of high school. I mean, eventually everyone else caught up, but I mean, the first 2 years, my freshman and sophomore year, I'm pretty sure I had the deepest voice in the school, which was kind of weird. Making announcements on the school intercom, everyone knew it was me. I'm like, oh, I don't want to do this. But nice game here, 10 catches, 213 yards, 1 touchdown, 3 drops, unfortunately. 352 recruiting points total. And heading into week number 3, we get a scholarship offer from Kentucky, Iowa State, and Indiana. And I decided to go with the Hoosiers in this situation. Obviously, no Kentucky because they're SEC. I don't want to overload on Big 12 teams, so no Iowa State. So I decided to go with Indiana there, even though I'm probably not going to go to any of the teams that were on that list. So here we go, getting started against Wilmette High School. And we've got our first road game of the season. And I actually love our away uniforms. I made these so nice. The white with the orange accents and the occasional black. I mean, these are probably the best uniforms I made. I love my Chicago Blackhawks uniforms I made with Team Builder, but I absolutely love these aways. These are just really, really nice. And here we go, 2nd and 5. Nice catch. Getting down inside the 2-yard line. It's going to be a gain of about 12 yards there. And so far in the game, I've caught every pass on this drive besides the first one. And it's been 5 straight. We're trying to make it 6 straight here on the 2-yard line, going in for a touchdown. As we run slants once again, this one is caught on the goal line, and it's going to be in for a touchdown. And I'll get things started scoring once again. Into the second quarter, we go up 7-0 still. 2nd and 7, running a curl once again. Quarterback throwing it a little late. This has got to stop. He's got to hit me as soon as I make that turn, but that's probably something to do with me. When you're running a curl as a receiver, you're taught to look for the football as soon as you turn around because the quarterback, as soon as you're making that plant to make that curl route, the ball is normally going to be coming right towards you if the quarterback deems you as open or if the defensive back really isn't paying attention. But that's just me. That's the way I've been kind of playing it here in NCAA. You see in the quarterback series, I was always throwing the ball before the receiver made the turnaround. Also in Madden, it's kind of just a thing that I'm taught, so I normally just use it. And now we're up 21-0 after that touchdown on the corner route. That one caught for a first down in traffic for 16 yards. Third down and goal here, going to the slant. This one is caught. Actually, that was a post route, and that one caught for a touchdown. And that'll pretty much do it here for week three. Pretty short game. You know, a lot of long touchdowns, not too much to see here. 17 catches, 261 yards, 4 touchdowns, 2 drops. And I'm officially a 3-star caliber prospect, 583 recruiting points, which should wrap up the scholarships from both Arizona State and Baylor for this upcoming season when I'm heading to college, and I did wrap up both of them. Also, Indiana. Forgot Indiana was on there. But I've got 3 to work with. Boise's the only one I don't have. And looking at scholarship offers from prospective teams, we've got West Virginia, Oklahoma State, and also Oklahoma, all Big 12 teams. And someone told me they wanted me to go to West Virginia, so I decided to go to West Virginia there and add them to my board just to have them on there. And here we go, getting week 4 started against Elk Grove High School. This return is going to be taken back, and I'm going to get down the sideline past the 40, past the 50, and push out of bounds inside the 40-yard line, gain of 55, and we'll get started from there. First and 10 here, a little later in that same drive. Curl route going to be caught for a first down. Got away from one guy, could not get away from the second. That one good for 17 yards. And on first and goal from the 5-yard line, going to the corner route. This one's caught for a touchdown, and just like that, we're on the board. One solid return, 2 catches, and that equals 7 points. Up 10-0 here against Elk Grove. That's going to be caught for a first down. And look at that man go down the field. This one's going to be a touchdown as he broke 2 or 3 tackles. Thien Nguyen, 58 yards for the score. And we're up 24-0 here in the second quarter. Quarterback's going to throw this one to the outside. Caught for a first down. That was a curl route that I turned into an out route because I wanted some space. Second and 10 here going down the field once again. This one's caught, ripped down for a first down, gain of 14. First and 10 here from about the 25-yard line. Curl route once again being turned into a post route. Caught for a first, getting us down inside the 10. And on third down and goal, what will we do here? Going to the outside. This one's caught for a touchdown. Did not drop that one. And that one good for 8 yards and a score. 31-0 lead here. Second down and 3. Turning that vertical into a kind of a corner out once again. Trying to get some room to the outside. And here we are late in the second quarter. Fourth down and 5. They're going to leave your boy open down the field. I'm trying to burn this safety or put a move on him. And I just cannot do it. And that got us down inside the 10. Second quarter almost wrapped up here. Quarterback going to launch this one to the corner of the end zone, and I'm wide open. They're not covering me. And we're down the red zone once again. Second down and goal. Fourth quarter just getting underway. Slant route caught for a touchdown, beating the zone coverage. And that'll do it here for week number 4. Elk Grove Village goes down 45-17. We stay undefeated, and I'm officially a 4-star caliber prospect. 11 catches, 142 yards, 4 touchdowns, no drops in the game, and I'm officially up to 763 recruiting points, which is going to secure the scholarship from Boise State and also from West Virginia. I keep forgetting the teams that we're adding in the prior week. So that's going to be 2 solid scholarships there, one from the Mountain West, one from the Big 12. And they throw Missouri at me and also Tennessee and Georgia Tech, and obviously no SEC teams this time around. So unfortunately, I have to go with the kind of a waste of a team, Georgia Tech, who runs that option offense. I definitely will not be going there. That's kind of a given. Next up here in week 5 is Orland Park High School. This one's caught for a first down. We're getting things started with the pass game quite nicely here as I'm getting a little more comfortable with the wide receiver position. This is something I'm really happy about because it kind of took me a while to get accustomed to in the earlier games. And I'm, you know, kind of learning to use some of the cutting moves to, you know, run curl routes, turn around, because earlier I was using the strafe button, which is kind of a headache to use. And I'm finding open holes in the zone, which is something I'm really liking. So here we go, getting this ball down inside the red zone as the second quarter is getting underway, and it'll be second down and 2, and I'm running underneath. This one's caught and diving in the end zone for the touchdown, and that one will be my first receiving touchdown, as we already have an interception on the game. First and 10 here, slant route up the middle, spin move, getting closer to the 5-yard line, good for 17 yards as we're trying to put some points on the board once again. First and goal, quarterback will drop back, fire for the end zone. I was open as well, but he fires for win, touchdown, 7 yard gain, and we're up 17-0. Play action play here, first and 10, going to the outside. This one's lobbed in the air, caught for a first down, 22 yard gain, and I just went up there and caught that football against the safety, looking like Eric Scott. That's who I want to be here. I want to be like Eric Scott from Missouri. That's my inspiration here for this series. I want to be down the field, one-on-one, beating safeties, beating corners, catching the ball in the air. That's what I want to do here. First and 10, slant route once again. This one's thrown in the traffic and surprisingly not picked off. That gets us down to midfield, good for 14 yards. Kind of surprised that one wasn't picked off. Going to the streak here, first down and 10, and the quarterback leaving me out to dry. But that's good for 21 yards. Hang on to the football there. Second down and 10 here, getting inside the 5 yard line. And we'll just punch the ball in on the ground. 31-0 lead here. They're not going to give me that inside route. So I'm going down the field, breaking one tackle, and I can't get away from the other one. The animations are killing me. Gain of 35. End of the third quarter, going to the corner of the end zone. That curl route wouldn't have happened, and that's going to be a touchdown. Nice job by the quarterback floating that ball towards the end zone. That one's good for 21 yards. First and goal here from the 5 yard line. Slant once again. This one is caught and in the end zone for another touchdown. This one from 6 yards out. And Orland Park High School goes down 48-7. We are firing through these games. I could have definitely done this for my Road to Glory series last year. As I have 18 catches, 261 yards, 3 touchdowns, 1 drop, and then 962 recruiting points. I'm still a 4-star caliber prospect. Probably one more game away from a 5. Got to break 1,000, I believe, to get to 5-star. But I'm not even upset about that. So we secure the scholarship from Georgia Tech, which is cool, even though I'm not going to be going to this team at all. And then we also have scholarship offers from Utah, Tennessee, and South Carolina. And I'm going with Utah. Obviously, Pac-12 team, no SEC teams this time around. That's kind of a no-brainer. But so far, so good with these college choices. I mean, a couple of Big 12 teams, a couple of Pac-12 teams. I'm really looking forward to getting some more Big 10 teams on the board. But here we go, getting started against Zion in week 6. Only 2 more weeks left here. And we're getting started with a pass down the field, good for 26 yards on the first play of the game. These guys just, they aren't ready. First and 10 here, going to the curl route. This one's going to be caught for a near first down, good for about 9 yards. And we'll go back to it here in the no huddle. Trying to see if I can get past this corner. I noticed that safety was coming up playing man coverage. But this time, I noticed it afterwards. I probably could have gone to the little cheating slant route or the corner route, but decided to go down the field here. Here we go, second down and 5, getting popped inside the 5-yard line, down to the 15, and we'll just punch the ball in on the ground. First and 10 here, going down the field, running to the outside for the corner route, caught for a first down, 25-yard gain. I got a little fancy on that catch, and when I get fancy is normally when I drop the football, but here we go, first and 10, another curl route, caught for a first down, getting away from a couple of defenders, but eventually brought down after a gain of 24. I was looking for a block from Weisbecker to maybe take out that guy who was trailing behind, but he couldn't get him. First down and 10, 2 minutes left here in the first quarter. This one is caught on the end route, caught for 14 yards, and we're going to keep the ball moving here. Going to the corner route once again. Another first down grab. Breaking a tackle nearly as I get 20 yards there, getting down to the 10. And we're trying to punch this ball into the end zone. Second and goal. Quarterback throwing to Weisbecker. Caught, touchdown. And our lead will increase here in the first quarter. Back on the field here. Red zone. 30 seconds left pretty much. And I'm running another end route. This one is caught. Nice move there. Sliding to catch the football. And we'll just punch it on the ground. Going to the stop and go. Look at the stop and go. Quarterback firing downfield, and I can't hold on to the football. This is what I'm talking about. Just the quarterback, if you just put a line on that football, I would have caught it and just kept going. But once again, I mean, I can catch the football when I'm getting hit like that really hard, but I can't catch the football when I'm just going up in the air. First and 10, another slant route. Making a move, getting away from one. Can't get away from the second gain of 18. That drive ended up stopping via an interception, I believe. So we'll get the ball back here in the second quarter. Trying to punch it in once again. Ball down to the 10-yard line. First and 10 going to the corner once again in the end zone. Caught for a touchdown. And I believe, what is that, my first in the game? I believe. So many touchdowns here. I don't even know what touchdown I have in each game. But a nice move here going across the field. That one probably could have been picked off. Quarterback threw it late, but good for 17 yards. Third quarter, and they're not even covering me. Touchdown as I'm in the end zone once again, 22 yards that time. Here we go, 42-0 lead against Zion going down the field. Going to go ahead and catch this ball in traffic and break a tackle. How do you like that? And we're back on the field here in the fourth quarter. Ball at the three-yard line up, 49-0, and I'm trying to end the game here. Going down the field, safety didn't step over, caught at the 30, and this one's going to go 97 yards for the score if I can keep my stamina together. And fortunately, I do as I fall into the end zone once again. 97 yards, and that'll do it here for week six against Zion, 56-7 win. What a season this has been. I cannot wait for the playoffs. I cannot wait to make that next step and tell you guys where I'm going. That should be coming out a little later this week, but we've got one more game to get through. Let's not get too ahead of ourselves. And I am officially a five-star recruit, 20 catches, 421 yards, four touchdowns in that game. 295 recruiting points, taking me up to 1,257. I don't know why I said it like that. But Utah is officially added to our scholarship board, so another offer there. And we have Missouri, Tennessee, and Iowa on the board looking at us. And obviously, we have to go with Iowa. No SEC teams this time around. I don't know why they keep throwing Tennessee at me. I don't want to go there. I kind of already skipped them, I think, like three times already. But here we go, final game of the regular season, getting started against Lakeview High School's our in-state rivals, in-city rivals. And this kickoff return is going to be taken to the outside, looking for some room to run, getting down to about the 40 and knocked out of bounds just shy of the 45-yard line. And that's where we'll get started. Going to the air here, second down and eight. Probably could have gone to the corner, but I'm running up the middle, breaking one tackle, breaking two tackles, and taking down at the 15-yard line. Good for 21 yards. Definitely not going to be breaking tackles like this in college, but here in high school on Heisman is definitely easy. I'm going right down the middle for 15 yards and a score. These touchdowns getting easier and easier each week with every single catch, every single game, every single rep. And I'm saying forget the corner route here. I'm going after the safety and is caught for a first down, getting us down in the red zone. Gain of 36 yards or just shy of the red zone. We're down at like the 23. But I went right after the safety on that one. I'm like, you know what? Let's just go up here. Let's attack the safety. And I came down with the football. And that one good for a first down. Drive still going as we're on the 11-yard line. Quarterback drops back in the corner. Where are you going? Touchdown. And that'll put us up 14-7 as we have a kick return here. Lakeview scores. We don't get a lot of chance for kick returns because we've been shutting out a lot of teams. So I'm trying to take this one all the way to the end zone for a touchdown. Blocks down in front. No need for him as I'm taking this one all the way for a score. First kick return of the season for a touchdown. And that one went 88 yards. And that one was close to not happening. There were two players who were diving for my ankles and they nearly got them. But nice score there on the kick return. And here we are getting the second quarter started. Third down and four. Caught for a first down. Broke one tackle. Couldn't get away from the second one. As that's good for 17 yards. Same drive still going here. First and 10 quarterback throwing this one down the field. That is tipped and is caught. I'm looking like Jermaine Kearse in the Super Bowl. The corner nearly had it. He laid out, tried to get too fancy, couldn't catch it. It went off of his shin, and I go down and I make the catch and get us down to the 10-yard line, looking like Jermaine Kearse. Let's hope that we can punch the ball in here and not throw an interception. That would really suck. So second and six here, bump and run. That is a little too easy, and I'm really hoping that the bump and run coverage is not this easy in high school or in the college portion of this series. As we go to the air here, third and 10, in route caught for a first down just barely as I got position inside the corner. 35-10 lead here in the third as we're going to the deep play, and this one is underthrown. I tried to go stop and go in the curl route, pull the safety up. It worked, but the quarterback didn't give me enough time. So it's going to be 35-13. We're trying to get another kick return for a touchdown. And this one's going to be taken to the outside. Room to run just slightly. And I don't have enough blocks in front. That one good for only 35 yards. Second down and 10. Quarterback will drop back. Fired to me on the curl route. Caught for a first down as I break a tackle. And not enough speed or stamina to get in the end zone. That one good for 23 yards. First and goal here inside the 5-yard line. Quarterback will drop back, roll out, find me in the end zone all alone. 4-yard touchdown, and it'll keep going here as we're on the field here in the fourth. Trying to get one more score, 42-20. Quarterback firing to me on the in route, caught for a first down. Now I'm taking off down the sideline, one man to beat, and I can't do it. And I just didn't have the stamina or the speed to get all the way in the end zone, but that'll do it here as we get pulled off the field. 48-20 win against Lakeview. And that's a pretty nice way to end the season. I actually like, I don't know, I made a lot of team builder uniforms. I definitely like Lakeview's as well. I probably would have used them. Maybe if I do another Road to Glory, if NCAA 17 doesn't happen, I might make one. But nice game here. 13 catches, 231 yards, 4 touchdowns, 2 drops, and 295 recruiting points, staying at a 5-star recruit. So we'll add Iowa to our scholarship board. They are officially locked in with a scholarship offer. And then we'll take a look at the next trio of teams looking at us at wide receiver. It'll be USC, Texas, and Stanford. This was such a hard selection to choose from, but I went with Stanford. USC has their, you know, national championships. Texas has their national championships. Stanford doesn't really have. Does Stanford have a national championship? I actually don't know. I should have looked that up. But here's a look at the final board here at the end of week 7. And up next will be the state championship game. I'm going to be skipping all of the first 3 games for the playoffs because obviously I don't think that people want to see that. Or maybe I'll just do something like I did with this one. I'll just put all of them into one episode. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. I already have 2 of the 4 games recorded, so if you want to see it, just let me know. But that'll pretty much do it for the episode. Obviously, up next, playoffs, and then after that, we'll be heading off to college, making our selection. I'm excited. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you guys are excited for the rest of the series. See you later.